What's up everyone, it's this guy, and today I want to do a video to talk about the different types of water softeners that are out there, kind of give you a little bit of information about them, and then towards the end of the video, if you're still watching, I'll get into a lot more detail about some of the systems that I've worked with. So for starters, there's a type of water softener system out there that actually isn't even a softener. It's an electronic conditioner. And the way that it works is it has coils or an electrode that'll basically be wrapped around the pipes or sometimes inserted into your pipe. And it uses electricity and it basically crystallizes the hardness or the particulates in your water so that they don't stick to your plumbing. The next type of system I want to talk about is a conditioner again, but this time it is a tank like this one right here. This tank is actually made by a company called Springwell Water, and if you can see their logo behind me, I'm actually a subcontractor of theirs. I've created a lot of their training videos and their instructions for them, so I'm very familiar with the systems. So this is a conditioner. It basically has resin beads inside of them, and the way that it works is as the water passes through, the hardness kind of interacts with the resin beads, and it basically crystallizes the hardness. So it's still there, but it won't stick to your plumbing. So the third system that I wanna talk about is a traditional salt-based water softener. And that's what I have behind me right here. Again, that one's made by Springwell, and it actually has a tank here, or a well, a brine well. You fill that thing with salt and then it softens your water. Now, the way that one of these works is basically the salt that's in the tank, it's like a salt water brine mixture, goes into the big tank here and it's full of resin beads. It looks like gel, like sand. It's very fine little beads in there, right? So as water flows through there, the sodium ions that are on this resin will switch places with the hardness of your water. They basically do this swap out. It's like this molecular thing, right? Not too sciencey. And then once the resin beads do like maybe 1,000 gallons or so of water, it'll regenerate in the middle of the night. And what'll happen then is it'll suck all that brine water out of the tank, the brine well. It'll flush it through the resin tank and basically flood it with salt. And then it does what's called a backwash, where it basically runs water backwards and it pushes all that salt water out of it, leaving only the resin that's been rinsed out. And there's still some salt ions in there, but it's not like salt like from the table. Now, there's a lot of concern with salt in your water if you got high blood pressure, things like that. There was an article that said that the amount of salt that remains in the tank is about what you're gonna find in a slice of white bread. Now, I don't know if that's true or not. You could do your own research. I've been using salt-based systems for over 10 years and I'm fine. If you have concerns, so you can install a reverse osmosis system under your sink and basically make drinking water. But in a nutshell, that's the basics. Now, for those of you that are still watching, let me get a little bit more advanced. Going back to the electronic systems, they work as far as neutralizing stuff, but you're not gonna notice any difference because there's no filtration, there's nothing happening. It's basically neutralizing the hardness and it's there. So it's gonna feel exactly the same when you wash your clothes or whatever. Your clothes will still be crunchy, still be starchy, your hair will still feel gross and gritty. If you go with the conditioning system that I showed you, which is just a tank with no salt, it gets a little bit better. You're still not gonna feel that super silky softness of softened water from a salt system, but there's definitely a benefit and you can tell the difference. Now, if you end up going with a salt-based system, you're gonna absolutely know the difference. So water feels slimy or slippery. A lot of people tell me like when they take a shower, it feels like you didn't rinse all the soap off of you, like you're still soapy, even though you're not. And that's because the water is soft. There's no particulate in there, there's no hardness. And that's what I love about a salt-based system. Now, I will say that not all water softeners are created equal. They're very similar. The parts and the components and the way they connect are very similar to one another. There's minor differences when it comes to water softeners. Some companies have proprietary additives that they put in, things that make them a little bit more efficient. The biggest difference when it comes to water softeners, though, is going to be the way the companies work. So, for example, this system that I have here, I bought it 10 years ago, paid way too much for it. It was a door-to-door situation. When I bought my house, there was a spigot on my sink that had a little label that says free drinking water system, just call this number. And so I called the number and this guy showed up and they did the sales pitch on me about water softeners, and I needed a water softener at the time. I just didn't really know what I was getting into. Now, I will say this, if you're looking to get a water softener system, which is probably why you're watching this video, be very wary of anybody who doesn't give you the pricing up front. They don't have the pricing listed on their website, or they want to negotiate with you, or they want to run your credit before they give you pricing. That's super shady. Now they're gonna maybe tell you like, oh, well, you know, maybe we have to do more work with plumbing. We can't really, how much is the system? Like, be very particular. I ended up paying $2,700 for this system. And now looking back with all of the information that I have now with my experience with water softeners over the last 10 years, I got ripped off. They didn't tell me how to operate the system. They filled it with rock salt, which is not right. I was filling it with rock salt for years, and eventually I created a YouTube video that showed other people how to maintain their systems, because the rock salt left a whole lot of mess in there. And so people were commenting on my video telling me that you're doing it wrong. And again, it was just because that's the way this manufacturer did it and did it and what they did in my house. And I was just mimicking that. On top of that, any issues I have with it programming wise, or any issues if the power goes out and I need to reset the head, there's no instructions on it. There's nothing on their website. You have to call their telephone number. They have to send a technician out, and it's $300 for them to show up. So I'm not trying to say they're a scam. Some people might love that, but I just didn't have a good experience. The other thing was, is with my Dipure water softener, is that it started to malfunction. So when it was backwashing, it wasn't doing it properly, and it actually started flooding my plumbing with salt. My water got salty, and my water heater blew out. Well, it didn't blow out. It rusted and then started leaking. It was corroded really bad. It's because there was so much salt in my water. And again, it's because the Pure system started to malfunction. So I had to replace the water heater. I did it myself, saved me a lot of money, but it wasn't easy. So I went to a spring well based system, and the one I'm actually doing right now, I'll be installing this myself right now, because I'm gonna upgrade to a better system. Okay, so welcome behind my set. I can't get any lights back here, so you'll have to bear with me on this, but this is the spring well system that I just installed into my house. Now, I'm a fan of Springwell, number one, because I did subcontract work for them. I did all their install videos and all their instructions, so I am a little bit biased. However, going back to the whole pricing thing, all of the prices are on their website. Clean as day. You don't gotta negotiate, nothing like that. Go online, figure out what you need. Boom, pricing's there. You pay it, system shows up. The other thing that I like about them is that they give you options and they kind of explain things to you. So for example, the system that I've got is pretty awesome. In the back there, that big blue tank you see upright, it's a 20-inch sediment filter. It's like a 5-micron filter. Not to get too technical, it just filters sediment out of my drinking water. Now, because I'm on city water, a lot of people think that that's not necessary, but I'll tell you, when I switch that thing out every 6 months, that filter is filthy. So it's picking something up. That silver tank that I have back here, it's kind of hard to see. That's a carbon filter. Now, the cool thing about a carbon filter is that it eliminates chlorine. Chlorine in your drinking water is bad for the resin in your water softener. The last system I had, nobody explained that to me. They were just trying to get in, make a quick buck, and get out. So the carbon filter, similar to what you have like in a Brita, or you know, like in your fridge, we have that filter that filters out your drinking water, except this is a gigantic version of that. The carbon at that thing is good for 10 years. So 10 years from now, I'll be swapping out the carbon in that system. Very easy to do. You could do it yourself. You don't got to pay a technician to come out. There's a video that I created on the website for Springwell that shows you exactly how to do it, and it's very simple. Then we have the softener system itself. Now, the thing that I absolutely love about this water softener system is that it's easy to use. And what I mean by that is that it comes with an app. So you can control everything from the app. You can basically go in there and tell it the water hardness, all this technical stuff. The instructions they provide you are gonna cover most of that. When it comes to water hardness, you basically Google your city, say, what's the water hardness in my city, and you just punch that in. You can manually regenerate it. The app is really cool. It's really easy to use, and I'm grateful for that because I'm an app kind of guy. I'm not a call the technician and have them come out and fix my stuff. So overall, with the combination of all the filters and carbon filters and all the different things that I have in there, it's like I'm showering with drinking water. It's amazing. I appreciate you guys watching this video. Again, this is just a high level video on water softeners. And yeah, it is a plug for Springwell because I've done a lot of business with them, but I wouldn't endorse anybody who I don't trust or who I don't think is right. I've always been very honest with viewers. And just to be honest, and they haven't paid me for this endorsement. I'm just putting a system in, and I figured it'd be a good opportunity for me to make a quick video to kind of discuss the differences for about the different types of water softeners. So I appreciate you guys watching. If you found the video informative, please make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Hit me a like. That keeps me going, keeps me creating videos like this or instructional videos around the house. If there's a particular topic you want to see discussed, hit me a comment below, and I can address that as well. Thanks for watching.